What happened is that when Krish met me, he first called me and, you know, wanted to narrate. And then when he met me, the moment he walked in, he said, "Oh my God, you're looking so young. I'm so happy." I was wearing shorts and an orange t-shirt, I remember. And he said, "I'm so happy you're looking so young. And, you know, this is a role of a 20-year-old girl. And you know, you still have that, you know." So he just went on and on and on. And I was like, wow, your maintaining did help. Web is such a lovely space. It's such a competitive space in its own way. There's so much good content from the West that people are exposed to, that if I sign up on something, it has to be heading the show. Hi guys, this is Rakul and you're watching Bollywood Hangama. Please do subscribe.
Rakul, welcome on Bollywood Hangama.
Thank you so much. How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
Very, very good.
All right, so looking forward to your birthday?
Yes. Birthday, so, and a release around the birthday and a lot of good stuff happening. So, yeah.
You share the birthday with Rekha ji?
Yes, I do.
And right up to you is Mr. Bachchan.
Well, you know, that used to be my claim to fame when I was a kid. You know, I'm a Libran and I share my birthday with Rekha ji and also with Amit ji being the next day. So, I used to really boast about it when I was a kid.
All right. Okay. So, and Libran women, apparently, they are the most beautiful. Aquarians come second. That's what Libran women says.
Oh, wow.
Are you aware of it?
I'm not aware of it, but I completely agree to it.
That's the confidence. All right. So, Rakul, how has been your past year? Like, right now, you're having loads and loads of films. But yes. How have you been your year?
It's been amazing, Faridun. I am very, very happy with the kind of films that I'm shooting for. And of course, the last 2 years have been sort of tough on everyone in terms of, the pandemic and the on and off scheduling that's been happening. You know, we've delayed films have not released. But having said that, keeping all that aside, I think just the fact that there's great work which has already been completed and then great work that's happening, which eventually will come out. I'm just sad about the fact that I wish, you know, those releases which were to happen last year would have happened if it wasn't for the pandemic, like Attack would have released or Mayday. But nevertheless, it's good work and people will see it next year.
Kondapolam, apparently you have been working out for... you work out anyways for De De Pyar De, and that's when Krish saw you and said that.
No, actually, if somebody happened to ask me, "Do you look thin in Kondapolam? Have you lost weight?" I said, "No, I haven't lost weight. I lost weight only once, which was for De De. When we met, we spoke about my whole weight loss and all of that. And after that, I've just maintained. I mean, I've just been maintaining, and it's been, what, three, four years now for that. But yes, what happened is that when Krish met me, he first called me and, you know, wanted to narrate. And then when he met me, the moment he walked in, he said, "Oh my God, you're looking so young. I'm so happy." I was wearing shorts and an orange t-shirt, I remember. And he said, "I'm so happy you're looking so young. And, you know, this is a role of a 20-year-old girl. And you know, you still have that, you know." So he just went on and on and on. And I was like, wow, your maintaining did help. So that's what happened.
Of course. And how are your gyms doing now?
Oh, they're doing fine. I mean, they were hit very badly with the pandemic, you know, because obviously gyms were the last to open. And also people don't really give so much importance to fitness, you know. So like how our cinema's been hit, even the gym industry's been hit badly. But I'm hopeful we'll recover.
Apparently, you gave some tips to Vaishnav Page as well, fitness tips to Vaishnav.
So yeah, so he was in the whole weight loss process during the shoot of the film. And he was like, "I'm not eating carbs." He wasn't eating his roti. And then we were shooting in such a difficult terrain. And I couldn't control myself. I couldn't hold myself back to tell him that, "Listen, don't do this." He was eating fruits instead. And I said, "You're spiking your insulin again and again, but you're not eating the slow absorbing carbs, the important carbs for the body. Like, you know, people think rotis are bad or your gluten. I mean, you can have your millets. And you can have your white rice and sweet potatoes in the right quantities." So I was just guiding him on that. I said, "Don't do your fruit juices. That is just waste of calories and not nutritious. So all those little things we were, yeah, but he's become fit now.
No, definitely he has. So, you know, with the sort of knowledge that you have with regards to fitness and nutrition, is that something that you want to maybe take up in some sort of like a YouTube channel, or does that excite you? Do you think that's a possibility for you?
That excites me a lot, and I do keep sharing a lot on my Instagram and on my YouTube channel. But definitely, there is an intention to do something bigger in this space once I have the time. Eventually, I think people are getting more and more aware about self-care. And you know, I've always believed that the only place you live in is your body, and what you sow is what you're going to reap. So eventually, I think I will do something to do with wellness and nutrition.
All right, and you know, right now you are doing so many films. You're doing films in Hindi. You're doing films in Tamil, Telugu. How do you just get into one space and then the other one? Different languages and different milieu.
You know, I've considerably cut out my work in the South because, yes, it was becoming very difficult to sort of balance multiple industries because of the way both the industries work. You know, one works in bulk schedules, the other in smaller schedules. So it was just becoming very difficult, which is why about almost 1-2 years back, 3-2 years back, I sort of filtered the work that I was doing in Telugu and Tamil. So right now it's more Hindi, with 5-6 films in Hindi and just one film each in Telugu and Tamil. Keep doing, because that's where I started. So, you know, Telugu being my home language, I mean, that's where I became Rakul. So I'll always keep doing that one interesting film for sure. And how do I manage? I think that just happens. Yeah. It's not about the language. It's about going from one film to the other. It's about understanding one character and then jumping into the other. So I think when there's a will, there's a way. I think it just happens.
Your fan following, they would want to see roles from you, performances from you, which are centered around you, because you have become this real life heroine, because you have stood up for yourself, and people want to see, you know, those themes which are centered around you. Except for example, what Tapsee is doing, for example. Is that something that is on your mind? Would you want to take up scripts?
Absolutely. In fact, I am doing something with RSVP, which will be officially announced soon, which has been in the news as well. But I will be doing something, and yes, that is the intention. I think films are such a lovely medium, Faridoon, to tell stories that need to be told, to tell greatness of real life heroes in real life. And I'm absolutely open to it, and I'm waiting to get such good scripts where I can sort of showcase a real life character that needs to be celebrated.
And what are the sort of shows that you've been following on WebSpace?
Last 3-4 months, I haven't really had too much time. I mean, it was the second lockdown that I saw a lot of shows, and I watched I saw Lucifer, I saw the new season of what is that show, the new Money Heist, the new season of Money Heist. More than that, I've been following up on films, but the last 3 months have been very slow. I saw Mumbai Diaries, which I loved completely. I thought it was such a gritty show. It was amazing. I saw Fauda. So yeah, here and there I keep watching something or the other, but last 3 months have been really hectic with because I completed Dr. G, and then I finished a large chunk of Akshay Sir's film, and now I'm shooting Thank God. So it's just been crazy.
You got any offers for web shows yet?
I have got a couple of offers, but nothing as exciting yet. Because I feel that web is such a lovely space. It's such a competitive space in its own way. There's so much good content from the West that people are exposed to, that if I sign up on something, it has to be heading the show, or it has to be completely path breaking, you know, otherwise I love my films too much. But I definitely feel that digital or web is the future. Of course, films will be films, that magic will always be there. But in terms of content and in terms of the variety of experimentation that you can do as an actor, I think digital offers a great space, and I'm open to it if something great comes my way.
What are your views on the way the characters are developed in the long format? Each character, it has more expanse at which they are just showcased. Does that excite you and does that interest you?
Absolutely, it does. Like I said, that there's such amazing content, right? And there's more depth into every character. It's not being concised into a 2 hour or 2.5 hour film where you're touching superficially different emotions. There's a backstory to everyone. There's a reason or a determination to every character. So that really, really excites me. And like I said, that I would love to be a part of something which is a solid character, which is possibly, I don't know, maybe a real life story again. You know what Quantico was for Priyanka Chopra, or even Huma was fantastic in Maharani. Or I love this show called Blacklist. So the female character in Blacklist. So I feel that there are such good characters with such depth of their story that can be told. It's very exciting.
You know, what we've also seen quite a few times, that say when actresses, for example, when they play characters which are in a way dominant, or which can be physically aggressive as well, or involving action for that matter, many a times maybe it is not accepted to that extent as far as films are concerned, because you know there are many factors, distribution sector hai, bahut se factors hote hain. But we have repeatedly seen on the web space that women have gone on to do very interesting roles, which are gritty, as you yourself said. They can be involving a lot of action as well, the way you said about Priyanka, or even Indian shows where they've showcased action as well. Does that interest you? Because considering you're having this fitness regimen, which can be, I think, tailor-made for you as far as action or anything of that sort is concerned.
I would love to do it, and you're actually right, Faridun. It's a very very fine line. I mean, it's a very, very true thing that people actually don't accept. There's not been a Tomb Raider sort of a film in Hindi. Why? You know, whereas an Angelina Jolie plays an action-packed role, and then she plays a romantic role in a rom-com. You know, why don't we do it? But I think that stereotype is sort of breaking. I personally feel whatever I have understood of it is because people like to see, or used to like to see, the heroines to be dainty and damsel in distress. Tapsee is doing amazing, variety of roles. And people are accepting those films. So I think it's been a parallel change with the kind of films which are being made, with the incoming of the digital content where people got exposed to that digitally first. So if we adapt that in our films, I think they'll be ready to accept it now. Like Deepika, I believe, is doing a lot of action in Fighter, is what I've heard or read from the news. So that's not going to affect or not let her do a rom-com if she wants to today. 5 years back, possibly it was a different thing. Hi guys, this is Rakul, and you're watching Bollywood Hangama. Please do subscribe.